Emily talks while drinking a Coke and eating a cheese stick. Welcome back to my YouTube channel! Yay! I can talk louder because my roommates... No. Scratch that. Reverse it. My sweet mates and my roommates are not here. They went home. So, I'm going to give you my tips for everything I've learned the first 2 weeks of college. I already recorded this once with these microphones, but the audio kind of turned out sort of bad, so redoing it without these. I'll find a good use for these because I'm not trying to waste my money. Okay, number one, everything's gonna be okay. I know you probably hear this a lot, or maybe not, I don't know. I heard this a lot and I didn't believe it, but trust me, everything's gonna be okay. It's very nerve-wracking the day before classes, but it's fine. It's not bad. Yeah. Number two kind of goes with number one. You are not alone. You have people to talk to, and it's gonna be all right. Yeah, just know you're not alone. Everyone's nervous. Everyone is just in the same boat, if not everyone, a good chunk. This next one I saw in a video I had to watch for one of my classes, and I thought it was really useful, so I wrote it down. You got accepted into the school of your choosing, or maybe not your choosing, but regardless, you applied to the school, and if you got in it, you got in it for a reason, meaning they believe that you are fully capable of succeeding in doing whatever you're doing. So if you're scared of failure, you might fail a few times, but they believe that you're capable of succeeding. Otherwise, they wouldn't have accepted you. I learned this, especially from being busy all the time and being a high school varsity athlete to not playing sports. You'll have a lot of free time. Maybe not, maybe you just have a million trillion things to do, but yeah, especially when you first get there and if you're not working. I will eventually be working, but not yet, so I have a lot of free time on my hands. Next one, this has worked for me. My roommate has not really been doing this and she's doing just fine, but this helps me, especially for someone who considers themselves an extrovert. But make at least one friend in each one of your classes. You don't even have to be like besties with them, even if you don't like them. Just have their number or their Snapchat, so that way you have someone to text if you have a question about the class or when something's due. Next one. I also need to follow this because I haven't really been doing this because it's scary. But utilize what you pay for. Meaning meal plans, dining dollars, the gyms and rec centers on your campus, all the tutoring things that they give you and are available, mental health stuff. Utilize it all because you are putting your money to college, so make sure you're getting everything that you can out of it. Yeah. You probably heard this one a lot of times, but don't take an 8 a.m. class. Don't do it. Even my classes all start at 9:30, and it's already a struggle as it is. I can imagine taking an 8 a.m. My roommate takes an 8 a.m., and bro, she regrets it. It's really hard for freshmen to do this, but try not to take Friday classes either. I know it's not possible a lot of the times, but if you have that option, do it. But yeah, especially if you plan on going out and partying a lot of college, or just not even. In college, you want to stay up a lot past your bedtime. But yeah. So I know this isn't really possible for everyone. Try to get to know as many upperclassmen as possible, or just one, because tips from them are very helpful, or just connections. It makes it better. Make friends with your RA if you can, you know? Before you register for classes, go on Rate My Professor. Even if you get, like, even if you end up having to take a class with a low-rated professor, it's still better to know what you're getting into than to just going in and then finding out you have a really bad professor. This one kind of hurts my heart sometimes, but you're not going to find the love of your life here. Maybe, there's a 0.01 chance that you will. Just don't expect to walk down the streets of your university and expect to have a gorgeous man walk down and then marry you on the spot. This is a dorm tip-ish, but make your dorm room as homey and as cozy as possible, because if you make your dorm a happy place, then you're gonna have a more likelier chance to be happy, I guess. I don't know. Maybe that's not the case for everyone. Check out the dorm tour that I did. But bright colors make me happy, and if I'm in a bright space, I'm more likely to be in a better mood. It helps for those lonely nights, which I'll get to in a second. Next one, go to class. It's good for you, whether that's just listening to the lectures or just sitting there in class, because a lot of my teachers personally take attendance, so it goes towards your grade. So go to class. Sorry. You'll notice about the second week, honestly, a lot of your numbers will go down in your classes and a lot less people will be showing up. But show up. Go to the events on campus. It's a great way to meet new people. I know it's scary, especially if you're going alone, but you probably will find someone else going there alone and you could be their friend. And yeah. I know at my university, we have a lot of like fun stuff like concert, crafts, all those types of stuff. Also, there's a very good chance if you go to those events, you'll get free stuff. Study tip, leave your dorm and go to a different location on campus if you want to get a lot of work done. I know if I'm in my bed, I'm more likely to just watch YouTube and go on TikTok. If you're actually trying to be productive and get stuff done, I promise you, you'll get a lot more done if you leave the dorm. I went briefly into this earlier, but you will get lonely, especially if your roommates and suite mates are not here. Exhibit A, it does get lonely, especially at night. Just relax, everything's gonna be okay, but try to distract yourself as much as possible and do things that you enjoy. Whenever you're lonely, it's better not to study at that time and to do stuff that makes you happy. Another thing, get into a routine as fast as possible. Whether that's just like one thing, like trying to get your work done by a certain point of the day, or going to the gym once a day. Try to get in a routine of something, because it'll make it'll make going into college easier. So, well, fun fact about me, my senior year of high school, first semester, I filmed my outfits every single day for TikTok and slowly started not doing that second semester because of soccer. Otherwise, I would have. But as someone who really likes fashion, trust me, you're gonna be wearing comfy clothes a lot of the time. Just how it is, you're gonna be very much more tempted to just throw on a sweatshirt and shorts and head out the door. So, yeah. Last one on my list, not really a tip, but just be aware that parking sucks. I got a good parking spot though, only because everyone went home for Labor Day, but I got a really good parking spot down there. Unless you're a commuter, it's gonna be a lot easier for you, but if you live on campus, just know it's gonna be a struggle. Be ready for anything. I got a call last night from my sister, and I already had my retainer in, already had my sweatshirt on, shorts, ready to go to bed. And then I get a call, ring ring, pick it up. Hello? Yo, get ready, we're going out. I'm like, okay, what for? Blah, blah, blah. We're gonna meet James Charles. And what did we do? We met James Charles. Yeah. If you're not someone who likes to go out at least once. This is the second time filming this, but I think we got it good. Yeah. I need to get better at curling my hair. Bye.